statement or a document the existence of which the court believes to be true or probable to be true, to be so existent that any prudent man would act upon its existence. That is proved. And in the line of proved is disproved and not proved. Disproved means when any statement or a document, the existence of which the court believes not true or not probable, then it is disproved. And if a document or an evidence is neither proved nor disproved, is called not proved. So, please understand, there are three kinds of evidence. First, those evidence which need not to be proved. First category are those evidence which need not to be proved. Three sections talk about those kind of evidence which need not to be proved. Section 56, Section 57, and Section 58 of the Indian Evidence Act talks about the evidence which need not to be proved. And what are those evidence? Section 56 says, the evidence of which the court takes judicial notice of need not to be proved. Once the court has taken judicial notice of any fact, there's no need to prove it. That evidence is admitted. And what court takes judicial notice of? The list of 14 items is given under Section 57. 13 items and 14th statement says all the history, science, arts, literature on the basis of old scriptures and treaties, court will take judicial notice of. And 13 items is the list given under Section 57, which says that all the laws of the land you need not to prove. The court will take judicial notice of it. All the acts of parliament, all the articles of war by army, navy, air force, all the proceedings of parliament as well as legislative assemblies of all the states, all the seals of the court, including that of notary, the court will take judicial notice of. You need not to prove. All the territories of India, all the recognized sovereign flags of the world, all the public gazetted offices by the state, their officers, their names, their functions, their signatures, you need not to prove. Even the commencement, continuation, and termination of hostilities against the government is a recognized fact by the court. And you would be proud to know that 57 says even the officers of the court, including lawyers, you need not to prove. All the rules of the roads, air, sea, need not to prove. All this is list given under Section 57. These are facts which are taken by judicial notice of by the court. You need not to prove it. They are evidence proven conclusively. And 58 talks about the documents which are admitted in writing by the party. Once it is admitted, where is the question of proving it? It's already admitted. So, but please remember, there is a catch. Don't get carried away. Admitted in writing is proven only against that person who has admitted it. That same evidence may not be an admitted evidence against the person who has not admitted it. So if there are multiple parties, one has admitted, the rest has not, so you need to prove against the rest as well. So it is only admitted by the person who has admitted it in writing. And remember, admission is suffixed by the word in writing. So 58 talks about the document admitted in writing need not be proved. Ye ho gaya first category. Ab hum aate hain second category, which talks about oral evidence. Oral evidence is governed by two sections of the Indian Evidence Act, 59 and 60. Section 59 and section 60 talks about oral evidence. And section 59 is a kind of a declaration. It's a declaratory note which says that everything except the contents of a document can be proved orally. Everything can be proved by oral evidence except the contents of a document. If you want to prove the contents of a document, then oral evidence is not enough. So 59 categorically states everything except the contents of a document can be proved by oral evidence. And 60 says that one must try to prove evidence orally. That means the more witnesses you have for your proving, the better is your case. So oral evidence except content of document ko chhodkar sab cheezon mein kaam aata hai. Jitne witnesses aapke paas hain, utna mazboot aapka case hai. Jitne witness box mein aap oral evidence laakar khade kar sakte hain, jo aapke case ko support karne, utna mazboot aapka case banta jayega. Ab aate hain third category pe, documentary evidence. Is documentary evidence ka ek chota sa part humne last time cover kiya, electronic evidence. To is baar hum electronic ko skip karte chalenge. Traditional documentary evidence kaise prove karte hain, hum aaj us par baat karenge. Because electronic to latest 2000 ke baad ka concept hai. Jo traditional method hai wo to 1872 se aa raha hai documents prove karne ka. Documentary evidence ki proving begins from section 61. Or proving of a document runs up to section 90 of the Evidence Act. Jiska ek bahut bada chunk section 79 se 90 tak to presumption hi cover kar raha hai. Jahan par phir court presume kar raha hai aapke document ki authenticity ko. To proving disproving ka to kaam ho raha hai wahan. Par jab aap 79 to 80 ka koi section 79 to section 90 ke beech mein jitne types of documents prescribed हैं, उनको court के सामने prove करने के लिए लेकर जाते हैं, और अगर आप plaintiff हैं, और अगर आपका डॉक्यूमेंट उस प्रिजम्प्टिव कैटेगरी में आ रहा है तो बेनिफिट इतना है कि द कोर्ट इज टिल्टेड इन योर फेवर ऑलरेडी बिकॉज द कोर्ट इज प्रिज्यूमिंग दोज डॉक्यूमेंट्स टू बी ऑथेंटिक एंड वेरीफाइड. But it is not that category of document which need not to be proved because the other side can rebut that presumption and can raise a question mark against that presumption. That don't believe this document to be true because I have certain doubts. To jo presumptive category ke documents hain, they are not of that category which is conclusively proved. Please understand this. Coming back to 61 onwards, जहां से documentary evidence की कहानी शुरू होती है. 61 says that evidence can be proved through documents which are of two kinds. Evidence can be proved through documents, that means documentary evidence are of two kinds. Primary document and secondary document. 61 talks about primary document and secondary document. So what is the difference between primary and secondary document? This is also defined under Indian Evidence Act. Section 62 defines primary evidence. And Section 63 defines secondary evidence. 62 defines primary document, 63 defines secondary evidence. Now, primary evidence means when we talk about that the documents can be proved through two methods, primary and secondary evidence. Primary evidence is when you produce the document as it is in the original form before the court. When the very original document is produced before the court, that is called primary document, primary evidence. But if the original is not in your possession, anything other than the original document when you are producing before the court, it is called secondary evidence as defined under Section 63 of the Evidence Act. And there are five categories of documents which are defined under Section 63 as the secondary document. Now here also, let me clarify one major confusion among lawyers. They consider certified copy as a primary document, which is not. Certified copy is not a primary document. Certified copy under Section 63(1)(a) is a secondary document. So when you are producing a certified copy of an original document, basically it is a secondary document. Secondary evidence. And proving of a secondary evidence, I'll tell you how it happens. Because when you produce the original as a primary document, proving is easy. The original itself has been produced before the court. But the moment you are producing a secondary evidence, then proving is different.